So I'm just gonna boot from the USB drive.
Okay, so what is Ubuntu exactly?
It's a distribution of Linux. It's one of the most popular.
Well, I've heard of Linux.
Have you ever used it? It's your operating system?
No, not really. I typed in a couple of commands into a Unix system decades ago. But yeah, I don't have any real experience using Linux or Unix.
Okay, well, here's the Ubuntu desktop.
Okay.
So let's see if you can figure it out.
All right. Well, what do you want me to try to figure out here?
Well, why don't you try connecting to the internet, first of all?
Okay, that's probably here. Server not.
Oh, you know what? It's because we're not connected to Wi-Fi right now. Okay, so it's connecting right now.
Okay. I'll give it a chance. Okay, so you still have...
All right, there we go.
Okay, so it's pretty much all icon driven, right?
Yeah.
There's no... I don't see any place where you can get a menu. Okay, there's your Firefox. Dash home, I wonder what that is. Oh, so you just have a search taskbar? Is that like a web search, or is that like... Okay, so there you go. Alrighty. Okay, so what about email? How do I get to email? Alright, so this is an operating system?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's kind of like my documents.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's fairly clean. I don't dislike it. I don't really see where the menu, like with the Windows 8 thing, they took away your start menu, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And you couldn't go and look at all your programs in a concise place.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like you can do that here either, unless I'm missing something. System drive. Okay, those are all...
Those are the flash drives and stuff that I have in my computer.
Yeah, but I mean, all these things are kind of analogous to the old, older Windows programs
mm-hmm.
that I'm familiar with. Just the kinds of categorization of tasks. So this is kind of like a Word document, Word program, I suppose.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, okay. That's not too bad. My complaint still is that I like to be able to see, what's on my computer in a hierarchical way. Like I want to be able to go to my computer or C drive or whatever and, go down through the trees if I want to, of all the various folders and subdirectories
mm-hmm.
and find what I need to find. And that's just kind of the way my mind works, so... I don't know. I suppose this has got it. I got access to everything I would need at some point, but, if it's me, I'm going to stay with Windows XP.
But if you were to choose, would you, if you had to upgrade, do you think you would go to Windows 8, or do you think you would go to Ubuntu
at
this point?
At this very moment, I like the Ubuntu. I feel like I'm more comfortable, with knowing how to access... stuff that's on there, the icons make more sense to me. I don't have to dig very far to get the basic stuff that I need. So, I like that. I'm still going to stay with Windows XP.
Yeah.
But this is not too bad.
It's good for free, right?
Well, if it's free, then it's even better.
Yeah, Ubuntu, you can download it off their website for no price.
Yeah, not too bad. All right. Yeah, this is one. I don't think I would mess around with Windows 8 much more, but this is, I would play with this a little bit more just to, out of curiosity, just to see if I could find my way around the computer a little bit better.
But
I don't know why.
But you like the way that Ubuntu works a little better than Windows 8?
Yeah, and I can't even put my finger on why. But I can tell you, having, you know, just sat down with a clean slate and not really knowing what I'm doing, I feel more comfortable with this presentation so far.
I mean, I didn't really even have to tell you how to get to programs. You know, it took you like 15 minutes just to get to the start on Windows 8. But you were launching programs really quickly with Ubuntu.
Yeah, well, just in fairness, I was looking for it when we did the Windows 8 demo.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I was looking, I wanted to find those things. I do here too, but I guess I just am not expecting as much of this as I did of Windows 8. I thought Windows 8 was going to be more like Windows XP. I didn't have that expectation here. But even with all that said, I still think that this is a more comfortable interface.
So, I'm not telling you to upgrade, but would you feel comfortable sometime if you had to, you think you'd feel comfortable switching to the Ubuntu platform?
If I had to.
Yeah.
That's the key word there. Yeah, no, I think, you know, if you forced me, you know, to have another computer with another operating system, I would probably end up being okay with this.
Yeah, because, I mean, in a couple months, well, the computers that stores sell, you know, every single one's going to be running Windows 8. Just like right now, every single one's running Windows 7.
I know. Let's just hope my computer lasts a long time then.
But if you got a computer with Windows 8 on it, you think you would switch it to Ubuntu?
Well, you know me, I don't like to change anything. I might spend a little time trying to get used to Windows 8 first, but, you know, if it still leaves me feeling less than satisfied, yeah, I would upgrade to Ubuntu.